Are you getting gaps like this in the top of your 3D prints? Well, there's a few tricks in Cura that'll help make it smoother like this without using ironing. I'll show you how to do it on today's Filament Friday. Filament Friday is brought to you every week by the generous donations of these Patreon supporters. This video is also brought to you by PCBWay.com, a great place to get low-cost circuit boards and low-cost assembly service, all at PCBWay.com. Here's a typical CHEP cube I brought into Cura 4.8. I'm going to use their super quality 0.12 layer height, slice this guy up, and let's take a look at the top of it. This is very typical, 45 degree angles on all the points, and this is the way it looks. A little bit rough. Not bad, but rough. That 45 degrees is a default. You can actually change it here at the top bottom line directions. If you put 90 in there, it's going to give you a 90 degree line, which is a horizontal line like you see here. This actually looks better on a print, but we ended up with this gap, and that's because of the line width. Well, let's take a look at this. So here it is printed out, and it's a little smoother, not much, but we have that gap. And I can actually put my removal tool in there. This is a painter's knife. It'll fit right in there. So now let's adjust the top and bottom line width. I showed this in a previous video. I'm going to go with the minimum, the 0.26 millimeters, and it comes out smoother. Now I still have a little bit of a gap here. We'll see if that shows up in the print. But overall, this should give us a smoother finish on top. And here it is. It's definitely smoother. This picture doesn't really do it justice, and that gap at the top is really, really small. So you can see it gets smoother as you go to the right, just on these settings. But when I printed a CHEP cube, I still had gaps. So there's one more thing I needed to do, and that is the skin overlap percentage. Skin is the layer that's on top. Let's go from 10% to 50%. Slice this and notice I got rid of the line at the top. Everything expands a little bit on the yellow, which is the skin. Here's the overall result. Much smoother, no gaps. It looks a lot better. One thing I didn't mention with these little yellow pieces in the corners, that's by default enabled to everywhere. It's fill gaps between walls everywhere. If you set it to nowhere, you end up with gaps. But by default, the profile has that set to everywhere, so you don't have to worry about it. But at least now you know what it is. Now that we've discussed that, I want to talk about the temperature controlled fan. This was in a previous video that I did. I did it to shut the fan off at a certain temperature so my machine didn't sit there and make noise. I explained the whole thing, how you hook it up to the motherboard, the schematic that I created to control the fan. I showed how I tested it, how I soldered it together and installed it on my printer, and that it worked. That, you know, here at 60 degrees, you give it a little bit of time, the fan comes on based on temperature. After that video, I had so many people asking for the circuit board, I decided to pursue it further. Now, I have released the open source files to the electronics area of my chepclub.com site. Anyone who's a Patreon supporter, silver or up, will have access to that. I'm also going to work with PCBWay.com to see if I can get circuit boards made for a low cost for anyone who's interested. If you have an electronic design like I do, maybe check out PCBWay.com for your circuit boards. They offer low-cost circuit boards at a very quick turnaround. They also offer PCB assembly, so they'll put the components on, solder in place, and give you a working prototype. So check out PCBWay.com. I loaded my Gerber files into the Gerber Viewer within PCBWay.com. It looks really good, so this is what I'm going to be sending to them. So when I get this settled out, I will let you know in a future video. So if you're interested in this fan control board, let me know in the comments below, and I'll see how I can get these to you guys at a very low cost. If you like what I'm doing here, maybe check out some of the videos that are popping up, and if nothing else, click on that CHEP logo and subscribe. I'll see you next time right here at Filament Friday.